What's he got this time? Let me see. A veritable bounty! Shiver me timbers! That'll earn you one of these trips to be sure.
Faulkner's guess better be right. Why anyone would believe the Northwest Passage exists is beyond me. The Octavius. Hendrik Vanderhall's first and last captaincy. Hendrik Vanderhall, Captain Kidd's quartermaster turned captain himself. The path you sought never existed, Hendrik. I hope your suffering was short. Get out of this thing! I must get out! That was close.
Press the rock that doesn't fit.
Remembering old times, Achilles?
Connor. Oh, yes, I suppose I was. Seems like so long ago.
Who was the assassin this belonged to?
Originally, it was John de la Tours, the first assassin in the colonies. Then it was mine for a time. The things I've done wearing that armor. Some are uplifting to recall, others very painful indeed. One day, I will hand it over to you, Connor. It is your duty to keep it. It serves as a reminder for how long our Brotherhood has really been here. How long we've been protecting the people of this land. But here I am going on again. I know you appreciate what it is.
back again? What do you got for me? Blow me, or you've earned the last of these blasted things. Be sure to let me know what you find, eh?
Joseph Palmer retired to Jamaica, somewhere around this castle. Faulkner said the scroll would likely have ended up in Lord Lewis Hutchinson's private museum. This place has seen much evil. Hutchinson's personal museum. Kid's scroll must be here somewhere. The shot must have come from the balcony. The killer must have chased his prey, but through where?
mechanism of the mask is broken.
I do not understand how anyone could live here. Small wonder Hutchinson went mad. This place feels mad. There must be some clues around that can help me with this.
close to a tree kissed by fire. Trust her?
With my life, Captain.
Hello. Name's Amanda. You must be the captain.
Now, what's all this about, then?
You stride into my bar off the piss and looking for officers. Days later, I start hearing whispers the ghost of the North Seas stalks the Atlantic again. The Aquila has returned, and I need her help. Nicholas Biddle now sails for the Patriots, captaining the Randolph. But the man is raiding up and down the coast round Nantucket, claiming it's a loyalist post.
Where is he now?
Speak of the devil.
Head below deck, Mandy. It's safer there.
I want to see this myself.
Randolph is attacking a merchant vessel not far from here.
Your orders.
We need to find out what Biddle intends, but we must hurry. What else do you know of Biddle?
All of a sudden, Congress has a brand new ship for him to captain. From British coxswain to captain of a colonial flagship, something doesn't add up. Heavy gust, Captain! Hard counter! That wind will push us hard up those rocks! Veer off! There's a storm coming, Captain. Feels like a big one. Sir, that could have been ugly. Another captain, she's all yours. Randolph has turned sail. Do we chase him?
We cannot leave this merchant vessel to the mercy of the English.
Why is Biddle doing this? Nantucket is for the Patriots!
The company we keep tells me his true allegiance lies elsewhere.
Cut of their jibs.
Where's the Randolph?
He's gone, sir. Cut and run. Left us to deal with this rabble. But this storm concerns me a great deal more.
We have little choice.
Aye. Time you stop pushing the waves, sir. Then we must find shelter, or it won't be cannon fire that ends us.
Mr. Faulkner, we make for the vineyard. I have never seen weather like that.
It's rare, but it happens. You did well. What's bothering me is Biddle's a patriot now. Why is he helping the British Navy like that? Old friends, maybe?
Well, how would you convince the Continental Congress the Navy needs more ships?
The rash of British raiding the coast is reason enough to address the gripe. Gunboats at the vineyard, now this.
Biddle aims to be the first admiral of the Colonial Navy and is making a case for the need.
That was some deft sailing, Captain. I was watching from the gun deck.
What were you doing on the gun deck? I told you to stay out of harm's way.
I'm fine, Bobby, not to worry. The people of Nantucket are surely grateful, and so am I. Glad you're back!
Our charge, Captain. The Belladonna, under Rodrigo Hortalis and company. She appears Spanish for all intents and purposes, but rest assured she's a French vessel.
French are bringing in a boatload of powder and guns for old Georgie and his patriots. Some colonial boats were supposed to escort her up the coast, but they left her behind. She's been waiting ever since.
We will make sure Washington gets what he is expecting.
Where is le Capitaine?
I am the Captain.
You are late!
We came as quickly as the wind allowed.
Too slow!
What happened to your escort?
Le Randolph started with us, then departed without warning. Typique! This is why le lieutenant insisted I come aboard.
English frigate!
The Belladonna! is down, Capitaine! We must stay closer!
Bloody hell! Pummel that Leviathan!
No! We board her. I must know how the English knew about the Belladonna.
We take her a prize, men!
Board her? Es-tu fou? Hawkinson, bring her close! To arms! To arms!
Man the swivels! Cover from the quarter deck!
Secure the aft line! Tie off the bow!
How does the British command know about the Belladonna?
British command knows nothing of this.
Then how are you here?
We were led here by a patriot, Nicholas Biddle.
Who does Biddle work for?
Oh, I think you know. Assassin.
What did the captain tell you?
Nicholas Biddle led them here. He said... The Randolph.
The Randolph?
Beat to quarters!
Belay that order!
He is putting us to his rudder. We cannot leave the Belladonna undefended.
But, sir!
She is incapacitated and vulnerable. Let him go. We will see each other again soon.